To all of you who are watching this, this video is a cry for help. In 2016, the former president of my country, Brazil, Dilma Rousseff, was impeached. This year, the Brazilian director Petra Costa has directed a movie about her impeachment called The Edge of Democracy. This movie has been nominated for the Best Documentary Oscar Award, and it's a film based on lies, where she tries to tell us that Dilma's impeachment was actually a coup and the beginning of the rise of fascism in our history. Nothing could be further from the truth. Dilma's party, the Workers' Party, has robbed this country as never seen before in our history. In her documentary, The Edge of Democracy, Petra claims that the corruption in our country has existed ever since the birth of our democracy. Which is true on some level. I mean, the Workers' Party did not invent corruption, but they sure did innovate it. You see, no one had done before what the Workers' Party did. They used their corrupt money and influence to bribe congressmen so they could stay in power indefinitely. Petra Costa exalts the figure of the previous president of Brazil, Luiz Inácio Lula da Silva, the biggest liar and thief this country has ever known.
The most popular politician on earth.
And he was arrested in 2018. The Edge of Democracy tries to show us that the only accusation against Lula was based on an apartment that he got from a construction company. Well, but there was way more than that. I mean, he's facing another 6 criminal prosecutions, and he's been convicted 2 times, one for corruption and one for money laundering. Speaking of Lula, there's a moment in the documentary where he asked the judge responsible for Operation Car Wash if he feels responsible for destroying the construction industry of this country. Excuse me, what? The Operation Car Wash is an ongoing criminal investigation made by the federal police from Brazil, and they have uncovered the biggest corruption scandal in our country's history. In fact, many say that it actually uncovered the biggest corruption scandal in the history of the world. And since we're talking about Lula and Operation Car Wash, I think we should talk about Andrade Gutierrez. Andrade Gutierrez is a construction company, of which Petra Costa is an heir to. In her documentary, she talks about her mother as if she was a complete stranger to the family's business, but that was also a lie. Actually, Marília, her mother, was a shareholder of the company and was deeply and constantly involved with the corporation's activities. And Andrade Gutierrez had to pay a fine of more than $50 million for participating in the corruption scandals uncovered by Operation Car Wash. The plot thickens. The investigations of Operation Car Wash concluded that a handful of construction companies were bribing congressmen so that they would be guaranteed to participate in extremely lucrative businesses. The same companies that Lula claims were harmed by Operation Car Wash. Another lie told by The Edge of Democracy is how Petra tries to hide the fact that the public opinion was mostly against Dilma. On March 13, 2016, we had the biggest political act in our country's history. Dilma wasn't impeached because she attacked banks and interest rates. No, in fact, her government was the one who favored banks the most in our history. So that's another lie. And she also wasn't impeached based on a technicality, as Petra Costa loves to say. No, she was impeached because of her government's fiscal and accounting frauds. In fact, our federal accounting office in 2015 rejected Dilma's accounts based on those fiscal frauds. And that was the main argument of the impeachment request. And by the way, the Workers' Party never helped with the income inequality of our country. In fact, a study made by World Wealth and Income Database concluded that the income inequality wasn't really changed during the Workers' Party government. Also, despite what Petra says, the rates of unemployment weren't the lowest while Lula was a president. They were actually lower in the 50s, 70s, and 80s. But the biggest intellectual dishonesty of this whole movie was actually implying that Dilma's impeachment was a result of a political ploy and political interests, that it was somehow orchestrated by her opposition to take her from power. That is the greatest insult of this movie filled with lies. At first, Dilma's opposition didn't want her impeachment, no. In fact, they wanted her to stay until the next election, so she would destroy the country even more, and those people could rise as saviors of the motherland. They wanted us, the people, to suffer more at the hands of the Workers' Party, just so that they could get power in the future. The impeachment process was only possible because common people fought for it. It was a struggle to convince politicians to vote for the impeachment. It was a struggle to be there at protests every month against Dilma's presidency. Our group, Free Brazil Movement, actually marched on foot from São Paulo to our capital, Brasilia, to file the impeachment request. and we actually made a documentary of our own, which tells the true story of Dilma's impeachment. The movie's available right now on iTunes. You should definitely go watch it. It's called The March for Freedom. We recommend you to watch it, so you can see the story that the Oscars and Netflix are trying to hide from you. This was a people's fight, not some congressman's or politician's fight. No, our fight. And no matter how many lies Petra Costa says, or what she does, or how many people see her movie, she will never take that away from us. This is why I need you to share this video to as many people as you can. In the description, I list every single lie that Petra Costa told in her documentary. Please go see it and share it with anyone who has seen The Edge of Democracy. That liar cannot win. Please, help us spread this message to the world. Thank you for watching.